who you were in the bunk with.
It's a gut-punching docu-series that purports to tell the true story of a case that left the city scarred, the 1989 brutal rape and beating of a female jogger in Central Park, and what eventually became a very public miscarriage of justice for five young men dubbed the Central Park Five.
All we need is for one to tie this whole thing together.
That is the portrayal of lead prosecutor in the case, Linda Fairstein, who since the docu-series started airing has taken a public beating of her own.
I'm sorry it's taken so long for people to realize what a monster Linda Fairstein was in that case.
Attorney Ron Kuby represented one of the men convicted in one of his appeals, Yusuf Salam. All five of the young men were convicted in the crime based on confessions extracted over the course of dozens of hours.
I didn't see a lady or hit anyone.
I didn't see any lady.
First, there's fear. It's cold in the room, right? They don't want you to sleep, so you got to stay up, right? There's no food, no drink, and that takes hours before they actually get to the process of questioning you.
The young men were eventually cleared of the crime, but not before serving time. Each was awarded millions of dollars for the injustice, even as they today continue to clear their names in the public eye. One of the young men who served the longest, Corey Wise, spent 13 years in prison, and during that time met the actual rapist, Matias Reyes, who eventually confessed to the crime and whose DNA was found on rape victim Trisha Mele's body.
A lot of times people don't understand. They'll see us and they'll be like, come on, just get over it. You guys are home now. But the reality is that we're still coming home.
Now the hashtag #CancelLinda is trending on social media, and a change.org petition has gotten thousands of signatures calling for bookstores to remove Fairstein's mystery books from store shelves. And after calls from numerous staffers at the nonprofit group Safe Horizons, a victims advocacy group, Fairstein has now stepped down from its board and deleted her social media accounts. Fairstein also stepped down from the boards of God's Love We Deliver, Joyful Heart Foundation, and Vassar College. She told the New York Post she was doing so due to what she called a mob mentality reaction to the series. And she claims that actress Felicity Huffman, who portrays her in the film, actually portrays her in an inaccurate manner. But she has continued to deny that the teenagers were coerced into confessing, and she defended authorities' conduct in the case. So it's probably not the last that we've heard.
No.